I see green across the board when that market opens in just a couple of minutes' time. Meanwhile, Keith Fitz is with us now. The markets like that Powell is sticking around. Do you, Keith?
Yes, I do. And I tell you what, it's a relief because it means we don't politicize the Fed. It means we get a steady hand at this tiller. And more importantly, it believes that traders do not have to have a knee-jerk reaction to what is potentially a catastrophic change in policy.
Separate case here. The Pentagon has awarded hypersonic missile defense contracts to Raytheon, Lockheed, and Northrop Grumman. That follows China testing that hypersonic missile, travel around the world five times faster than the speed of sound. Are you telling your clients to buy Raytheon, Lockheed, and Grumman?
Yes, we actually have been on board with Lockheed Martin immediately after the Chinese test. We've been on board with Raytheon for quite some time. Northrop Grumman was a new one to me. I didn't expect to see them in the mix, but now it's on the shopping list.
Because of the missile development, that's it?
It is. Well, I mean, they're all great companies. We own them for different reasons to begin with. So you got avionics, engineering, intelligence provision, space programs. All of these things are already there. But this game, this is Sputnik 2.0, and the United States has got to respond. These are the only companies capable of mounting the response. So we do want to own them because this is the playbook going forward the next 10 years.
Are you still on track for more gains towards the end of this year and into next year? You're nodding your head. You're still on board with the rally?
Oh, yeah, we are. You know, and Powell it still has to go through confirmation, and he's going to face a cantankerous bunch of folks who want to unseat him. But you know what? So what? I think that if the known stays with us as opposed to the unknown that we could have had, yes, all that money's got to go somewhere, and it's going to go to the world's best companies, and most of those are right here in the United States at the moment.
You know, there is an optimistic scenario developing here. Front page of the Wall Street Journal, the supply chain problems are easing. Price of oil down to $75 a barrel, implying that maybe gas prices, the rise in gas prices, may ease. That's an optimistic scenario for next year. Are you buying it?
You know, here's the interesting thing, right? There's still lots of headwinds, but I don't agree. It's the right idea, wrong nuance. I don't think the supply chain bottlenecks are easing. What I see happening is innovation across the board overcoming it. And that's a very different scenario and why I want to play forward. Because it's one thing to sit back and watch the world go by, but America, innovation, these are things that actually help the world go by. That's the investments you want.
So all of your clients' money you put into stocks at this point? Because this
there are bonds. I mean, you've got to own some other things. You've got to have a smattering of other things. You've got to concentrate in the world's best companies, margin protection, inflation protection. So there's a lot of themes running through what we're doing right now. So it's not exclusively stocks because you still have volatility and leverage in the system. That's a risk. But again, going forward, the single biggest travesty for most investors, Stuart, would be missing the opportunity that's unfolding, not trying to avoid the risk they can't control.
Okay, I'll try to avoid missing opportunity.
Good.
I'll give it my best shot at least. Keith, you have a great Thanksgiving. Thank you very much for being here. We'll see you again soon.
You too, sir.
Keith Fitz-Gerald, everyone. 20 seconds to go.
Hi, it's Keith here. Thanks for checking out today's highlight clip. What'd you think? Did I make sense? Is there something you'd like to add? Make sure you leave a comment down below. And of course, click subscribe to keep up right here on YouTube, or sign up for the email newsletter at the link below. You can also find me on Twitter and Instagram for my real-time thoughts on markets, analysis, and a whole lot more.